Large language models today commonly utilize transformers as their backbone architecture. Transformers have proved to be an extremely capable architecture, driving large language models to achieve remarkable results which revolutionize our lives. However, their memory consumption and efficiency are quadratically dependent on the sequence length, which makes them very expensive to train and run. Therefore, state space models such as Mamba have gained a lot of interest thanks to their linear dependency on the sequence length, which allows them to be extremely fast. Despite Mamba's impressive speed, transformers remain the top choice due to their overall better performance. Specifically, state space models struggle with memory recall tasks, meaning their ability to utilize specific information from previous contexts is not as good as that of transformers, especially if the context is large. Perhaps all the Mamba needs is a little attention? Today, we're diving into an intriguing research paper from Nvidia titled Hymba, a hybrid head architecture for small language models. This paper introduces a hybrid approach that unites the strengths of both transformers and state space models, offering a balanced solution for high performance and efficiency. Nvidia has also released a Hymba model that achieves state-of-the-art results for small language models, demonstrating the potential of this method. Let's jump in to understand the hybrid head module in Hymba, the building block of the model. We'll use the following figure from the paper to guide us. We'll start with a high-level description and gradually add more details. On the left, we have the input tokens. In addition, we see that metatokens are added in the beginning of the sequence. These are learnable tokens, and we'll explain their role a bit later. Then, we have a linear input projection layer, which prepares the input to be processed by the core of the module. At the core, we have parallel attention heads and state space model heads, and the output from the input projection layer is split, so each head gets the input it needs. For example, for the attention heads we obtain the key, value and query matrices calculated using dedicated weight matrices as part of the linear projection layer, as usual. And similarly, the state space model heads get the inputs they need. Once the heads process the inputs, we want to combine their results. However, the researchers noticed that the magnitude of outputs from the state space model heads are consistently larger than those from the attention heads. To address this, outputs of both type of heads first pass via a normalization step before being averaged together. Finally, a linear output projection layer projects the output for the next component in the model. It is worth mentioning that previous hybrid models combined attention with state space models sequentially rather than in parallel. This may be less ideal when handling tasks that are not well suitable for a specific head type. Inspired by multi-head attention in transformers, where different heads learn to take different roles, Hymba is built with parallel heads, so each head can process the same piece of information in distinct ways, which allows to inherit the strengths of both type of heads. We'll now try to interpret the module from a human brain perspective. But before that, if you're finding this content valuable, don't forget to subscribe and hit the like button to support the channel. We also send 1-minute read summaries by mail about the papers we review here. You may find the link to join in the description of this video. Let's now take a moment to interpret the hybrid head module using an analogy to the human brain, using the following figure from the paper. In the human brain, we have different types of memory processes that work together to store and recall information. Imagine that the attention heads in Hymba are like snapshot memories. These are the detailed recollections we have of specific moments or events, allowing us to remember precise details when needed. Attention heads in Hymba work similarly, providing high-resolution recall of specific information from the input sequence. On the other hand, the SSM heads in Hymba function more like fading memories. These are the types of memories that help us summarize the overall gist of past events without retaining all the details. SSM heads efficiently summarize the broader context, ensuring that the model can process long sequences without the computational burden of maintaining high-resolution details. By combining these two types of memories within the same layer, Hymba's hybrid head module mirrors the way our brains balance detailed recall with efficient summarization. This design enables the model to handle various types of information flows and memory access patterns more effectively. Meta tokens in Hymba play a role similar to meta memory in the human brain. Meta memory helps us recognize where to find needed information in our memories. Similarly, meta tokens guide the model to focus on relevant information. In the following interesting figure from the paper, we see the average attention scores received in the last layer of the Hymba model for three different task domains. Noticeably, different meta tokens are activated for the code domain than those of the math and article domains. It could be an interesting extension to try and use different meta tokens for different tasks. Practically, meta tokens play another role of helping to mitigate attention drain, where certain tokens, often called sync tokens, receive disproportionately high attention weights. Now that we've covered the Hybird-Head module, let's take a step back and look at Hymba's overall architecture using the following figure from the paper. Hymba is built by stacking multiple Hymba blocks. Each block consists of a normalization layer, followed by the Hybird-Head module we covered, another normalization layer, and a feed-forward network. Next, we can see that only the first, middle, and last blocks utilize full attention that uses all of the tokens. All other blocks utilize a technique called sliding window attention. This approach allows the model to focus on local context within a sliding window, significantly reducing the size of the key value cache required for attention while still gaining global attention thanks to the three full attention blocks. Additionally, for the sliding window attention blocks, Hymba employs cross-layer key value cache sharing between adjacent blocks. Instead of each block maintaining its own separate key value cache, adjacent blocks share their key value caches. This sharing strategy reduces redundancy and memory usage, resulting in a more efficient model. This follows recent research showing that key value caches in adjacent layers share a high similarity. Let's move on to see some of the results presented in the paper. In the following table, we can see a comparison of Hymba with state-of-the-art small language models. We can see that all models have less than 2 billion parameters except Llama 3.23b, where the evaluated Hymba model has 1.5 billion parameters. Jumping to the last column, which shows the average performance, we see that Hymba outperforms all other models, which is extremely impressive. Furthermore, we also see that Hymba was trained on 1.5 trillion tokens, while the other three top models behind it were trained on 9 trillion tokens or more. Before scaling Hymba to 1.5 billion parameters, the researchers conducted ablation studies with a 300 million parameters model to evaluate the importance of various architectural decisions. This is a great way to recap the ideas we've discussed. At the top two rows, we see results for Transformer and Mamba before applying Hymba's innovations. The Transformer shows high recall compared to Mamba, 40% versus 19%. However, Mamba is significantly more efficient, processing many more tokens per second and consuming almost no memory compared to the Transformer. Next, we see the results for models with hybrid Mamba and attention heads. The upper row represents sequential heads, and the bottom one represents parallel heads, as done in Hymba. While the sequential heads already significantly improve the results and reach high recall, the parallel heads architecture achieves even better results. In row C, we see the impact of using sliding window attention for all blocks except the first, middle, and last ones. This technique significantly boosts compute and cache efficiency, with only a slight performance hit. In the next row, we can see that the key value cache sharing between adjacent layers further improves cache efficiency, as expected, without damaging the performance. Lastly, adding the meta tokens nicely improves the results without a significant efficiency hit. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for more reviews of AI papers.